Welcome back to the Crocker Science Center Laboratory Informational Video Series. Today we're looking at how to use another fundamental piece of laboratory equipment, the Bunsen burner. Now, Bunsen burners are used in a variety of laboratory courses, and from sterilization of glassware to thermal decomposition of material, Bunsen burners have many practical uses, and knowing how to use one properly is both a useful laboratory skill as well as a safety consideration. The first thing to think about when using a Bunsen burner is that you're working with an open flame. So before starting to work with one of these burners, tie back any long hair, or you'll wind up looking like me. Lab coats and clothing that are worn while working with a Bunsen burner should be natural fiber, such as cotton. This will provide a little bit more protection than synthetic fibers in the event that your clothes or lab coat catch on fire. Always remind yourself where the safety shower is in the event of an emergency, and keep in mind that if a safety shower is far away from you, it may be better to stop, drop, and roll where you are should your clothing ignite. Now, Bunsen burners usually have two ways to control their flame size and intensity. They may have a gas flow control and or an air flow control on the burner. Let's take a look at those now. This knob towards the bottom of the Bunsen burner is the gas flow control on this particular model and will modulate the amount of gas reaching the burner even if the gas knob on your bench is fully opened. The air available for combustion is controlled by turning this cylindrical piece at the bottom of the base of your burner. Control of the air and gas flow allows you to tailor the Bunsen burner's flame to suit your particular application. To start a Bunsen burner, you'll need a striker. The striker will produce a spark that will ignite the gas coming from the burner. It consists of a tiny piece of flint, which is rubbed across the rough metal surface inside the striker. If you ever see that this flint is worn down and is no longer visible, let your TA or instructor know so it can be replaced. Before using your Bunsen burner, start by making sure your gas hose is in good condition and doesn't have any holes. Then, ensure that both ends of the hose are secure, one to the gas outlet on your bench, and one to your burner's gas inlet. Also make sure your Bunsen burner is not directly underneath any shelving or supplies. With the burner positioned away from overhanging items and fellow lab mates, turn the gas all the way on at the main control knob. Then, use the striker to ignite the Bunsen burner. If it does not ignite quickly, turn off the main gas flow and let the released gas dissipate before trying to light the burner again. Also ensure that the gas knob on the bottom of the burner is not closed, since this will stop gas from flowing into the burner and prevent any attempts at lighting it. Once your burner is lit, the flame may not be suitable for your intended application. You can adjust the air intake and gas flow on the burner to adjust the flame size and intensity. For instance, notice how adjusting the gas so that the flow is less lessens the size of the flame, and then changing the air intake gives us a cooler flame. Similarly, as we increase the gas flow, the flame gets larger, and we can modulate the air intake to give us a double blue cone flame. For many applications, you'll want a double blue cone. Notice the outer blue cone and then the inner blue cone. It's the tip of the inner blue cone that is the hottest part of the flame. Never leave a Bunsen burner running when you are not actively using it. When you're done with the Bunsen burner, simply turn off the main gas control on your lab bench. Keep in mind that the burner will remain very hot for a while after it is turned off. As always, if you have any questions, let your TA or instructor know.